Most boats, like the Kaministiqua sailing on the Great Lakes today, are equipped with Thordon compact water lubricated bearings. They were built with oil systems, but most have been converted. Thordon Bearings began offering water lubricated shaft bearing systems in 1965 and has continued to supply only water lubricated bearing systems. A seawater system is extremely simple and offers long life. Water is taken from the sea, pumped through the compact bearings, and returned to the sea. Let's take a look at the components in the system, and then we'll explain the engineering behind each of the elements and how they work as a system. Seawater enters the vessel through the sea chest, where an element of crude filtration takes place. The water then flows to the suction side of the pump, built into the Thordon water quality package. Water enters the separation bowl tangentially, and the spinning water throws dirt particles to the outside, where they fall down the column to the collection bowl in the base. Clean water, with particles having a size less than 50 microns, flows vertically to the outlet at the top of the bowl, and then through the flow meter to the stern tube. Some water is diverted to the forward seal for cooling and lubrication. Sediment and water are legally discharged overboard on a timed basis by this purge valve, controlled automatically by the electrical panel. Water flows to the after engine room bulkhead and cools and lubricates the SeaThigor seal as well as the shaft bearings. There is only one seal used with a water lubricated system, and that is in this forward position. Thordon has designed the SeaThigor seal for the bulkhead position. This seal is what is called a stationary balanced axial face seal. It is designed to operate with the sealed water acting against the outside diameter of the seal faces. On the inside of the faces is the ambient pressure of the engine room. A pressure gradient is established across the faces from the pressure inside the stern tube to ambient. The after face rotates with the shaft, and the forward face is stationary and spring-loaded. The springs push the stationary face aft toward closing the face gap, and whatever the hydrostatic pressure is at the depth of the propeller, this pressure is assisting the springs by pushing against this area in the same direction as the springs. Both SeaThigor seal faces are made from silicon carbide to resist abrasive wear. The water film thickness between the faces is so small that practically all particles that might be able to cause wear are simply blocked from entry. This seal package contains an emergency seal. It is activated by air pressure and closes down on the shaft sleeve in a radial way. This allows maintenance to be done on the main seal if needed, without the leakage of water. In this test, we forced the seal to leak. Then we engage the emergency seal, and with the shaft still turning, leakage is minimal, and the ship can return to port without causing further damage. This forward stern tube bearing typically is a 1-to-1 length diameter ratio. Early compact bearing installations used a split key arrangement to secure the bearing in two halves, as you see here. However, life experience with so many bearings fitted now justifies a more economical single fixed key at the 12 o'clock position. Thordon still supplies many installations like this one where the bearing can be removed for inspection or replacement with the shaft still in place. The bearings are typically fitted with their carriers to the stern tube using epoxy resin chocking. This is the easiest and least expensive way to achieve proper alignment. Shaft liners, usually made of gunmetal or bronze, are shrunk on the shaft in way of the bearings. Alternately, welded coatings may be applied. Between the liners, a corrosion protection coating is used. Thordon uses a homogeneous coating, avoiding the wrapping process and the possible transmission of water under the surface, where it could attack the shaft in an unknown location. Perhaps the most critical area is what is known as the transition between liner and shaft. The liner is machined with a ramp designed to ensure the best grip of the coating. The aft bearing is much the same as the forward bearing, although based on the loading it will typically see in service, it is usually twice as long or twice the diameter of the shaft under the liner. Seawater passes through this bearing from forward to aft. The water flows through the grooves in the top half, and as the shaft rotates, a film of water is drawn down to near the bottom where the pressure is greatest. The shaft is supported on a film of water. The bearing retention flange or keeper plate prevents the bearing from moving aft and is also a suitable location for anodes if they are required. The rope guard or fairwater encases this area and contains holes for the water exiting the bearing to escape to the sea. Oil seals are easily damaged by monofilament lines. Water lubricated bearings are usually not vulnerable, and so these devices are not required. Engineers are familiar with oil analysis to show evidence of wear in a metal bearing system. All water lubricated bearings wear normally, and this wear is recorded at the time of dockings or afloat, traditionally a diver with a poker gauge. Another possibility for inspection of the shaft when the vessel is dry is to open an inspection port or window in the stern tube. The water quality package transmits flow data to the engine control room, and an alarm warns of loss of flow. Cruise ship wear down experience is suggesting a life for compact bearings of 30 years, although we have to date in this sector only accumulated about 15 years of history. With shaft withdrawal mandated at 18 years, this might be the best time to renew the bearings and resurface the shaft liners.
I'm the third engineer on the Kaministiqua. I've been on this vessel for about 6 years, and I was on board when they installed the Thordon bearing in Erie, Pennsylvania. That was almost 2 years ago. We had an oil bath bearing, which was removed because, you know, for pollution. We're kind of nervous about the pollution aspect of it, and our water-cooled bearing is, you know, has been good. There's been no problems with it whatsoever. Easy to maintain for us because we don't have to worry about adding oil or leaking oil back out into the environment. So it's a good fit for a ship.
Water lubricated shaft bearings had many years of almost universal usage from the late 1800s to the 1950s. Today, the only difference is that the shaft does not need to be drawn for 18 years compared to 5 years in the past. Thordon's compact package should operate trouble-free for 18 years or longer, with none of the heartaches of seal damage or seal lip renewal. You'll also have total freedom from issues of oil leakage. That can only mean cost savings to the ship owner, not to mention peace of mind.